Alrighty, time for round one. I would, in fact, like to play first, and, well, glad I put in this Tattered Haunter, since I'm just going to go 2, 3, 4 on the play, and if I draw an Emerge creature, that's great, but even if I don't, this hand is pretty good, so I'm happy. Alright, and go. Lashweed Lurker, of course, would be the one I would want to draw. Nagging Thoughts. You know, Nagging Thoughts might not actually the worst draw here. When I am done curving out, it means that I'm less likely to run out of gas. That part's good. Oh, hello there. So it is annoying that Sigurdian Priest is going to lock down my Lashweed Lurker. I mean, I could put the Priest back on top and get at least an attack in, but Priest is a good card. Yeah, generally, Priest is pretty good against blue-green. It's just all their big creatures are not humans, and they end up having a lot of good options for them. All right, I'm just going to attack first, or try to. So my phone's letting me attack. I'm worried about that Drogskull Shieldmate, the 2-2. Let's just not attack with Exultant Cultist here. And let's play Drenau Corpse Trawler. I could lurk. I could not. What do you have it? So, next turn, I have 4 mana. I could Lashweed Lurker, tapping the 4, putting Sigurdian Priest back on top. See what my opponent does here. True Fate Censor. Okay, well, that's not a very great play against what I have going on right now. Really? Yeah, that attack is a little aggressive. So now I could put the Shield Maid back on top, and then that lets me attack with a bunch of things. Or I could also actually I can even wait on the Lashweed Lurker. So what I'm gonna do now is attack with these three, not attacking with the Corpse Trawler. If my opponent blocks, I'll aim high. And then I can also cast Nagging Thoughts if I want. Aim high. Opponent takes 4, goes down to 12. I kill that. And then one of the reasons I'm not worried about playing a Lurker yet, take out the Horde Swarm, sure, is that my opponent is spending their mana on like stuff like True Faith Censor. If they leave mana up for Priest, then maybe it becomes a little better to play the Lurker, but if they're not even using the Priest, then it doesn't matter that much. Choking Restraints, wow. Yeah, things worked out really well for me here, didn't they? All right, let's go to attack, hit for 3, and then, jeez, this is just sack the emerge, the cultist to emerge. Your choking restraints goes away. Draw a card, Lashweed Lurker, your Sigurdian Priest. Just that is just filthy, and my opponent's just dead now. They're dead by a lot, actually. Yeah. I guess we'll send with these two. Actually, if they block the zombie, they go to 1. Yeah, I think this is fine. We go to 2. And then I guess I'll emerge off of Drenau Corpse Trawler here. And now my opponent's at 2, and I have 5 creatures in play? 6 creatures in play? Yeah. Alright, so I'm playing it's green white. I could put a Spring Sage Ritual into play because they have True Faith Censor and Choking Restraints. Those are both like real cards that I would like to kill. Take out Might Beyond Reason, I guess. Let's try that. Alright, this hand's not as good as the other one. I'm going to keep it. Gnarlwood Dryad makes this hand a lot more keepable because it gives me time to deploy my larger things. Ooh, Fortune's Favor. Alright. Well, Fortune's Favor makes it less likely that I flood out if I can survive. So, Guardian Priest. I will, in fact, offer the trade. Ooh, Exultant Cultist was an amazing draw. Get to next turn, play Cultist, and turn after that, I could play another Horde Swarm. I could also just play Provisioner and smash with a 4-4 Exultant Cultist, and play It of the Horde Swarm later. No attacks. Let's see if my opponent taps down my Gnarlwood Dryad. They do. Let's just play an Exultant Cultist. So I could next turn, I could swarm them. But given the fact that Swarm gets stopped by Sigardian Priest, let's just go Provisioner, which is a human, and make my other human bigger, and end up in a spot where Sigardian Priest can't really do all that much to stop me. So I kind of like that. Opponent just stuck on three planes. Yeah, this is not going to last long, unfortunately, for them. Still leave Cultist back in case my opponent has a Drog Skull. If they play Drog Skull and double block, I'll just trade for the Priest and then flash in Draenor Behemoth off of Exultant Cultist, probably. Okay. Trading there, yeah, I'll just pass. So they did have it. Alright, so they drew green, so maybe they'll be able to play some cards this game. That would be good. It's going to be pretty tough for them to win, even if they've got a good play this turn. Not impossible, just tough. Whoop, there we go. Drownyard Behemoth coming in. So I have a 5-7 and a 3-3. I guess I hope I don't get hit by Silver Strike. Alright. Looks like a combat trick of some kind. Woodcutter's Grit. Alright. So they go to 7 now. And let's go Primal Druid plus Shrill Howler. Since I could sack Draenor Behemoth to play It of the Horde Swarm, that doesn't seem like a particularly good play. Next turn I can play It off of Primal Druid. That was a It with a capital I instead of just It with a, you know, lowercase I, which I would actually work for referring to It of the Horde Swarm when it was the last thing I talk about, since, you know, the pronoun would obviously go towards that. But I just want to make it clear that I was talking about the proper name, It of the Horde Swarm, not It as in the last thing I said. That was also like an incredibly useless monologue, but we're here. All right, so Lunarch Mantle on the Drog Skull Shield Mate, making it a slightly better blocker. Draenor Behemoth still coming in. Yeah, I guess if my opponent has a combat trick, they might be able to be in a spot. Well, there's not that many combat tricks that actually work here, so never mind. Let us emerge off the Primal Druid. Get another island. Whoop, excuse me. I'm allergic to not curving out, and I have an island untapped here. I'm hoping to, you know, spend all my mana every turn. Opponent's on 2, and once again facing down a million gigantic things, so it's going to be tough for them to win this game. I guess they could prevent all non-human damage or something. That's a card, right? I don't know if they don't have that, then... Oh, they do! Alright, but their creatures are human too, so it just is a fog. I could play the Geist, but I'm just not going to bother. Probably not going to bother casting Fortune's Favor either. Just because I believe this game is about to be concluded. We'll see what my opponent does on this turn here, but again, it has to be pretty amazing. All right, and I guess that'll do it. We win match 1.